So we'll be discussing about the hypothalamus in this video. Now, first of all, neurosecretory cells. Let's learn a little bit about neurosecretory cells. These are actually a specialized neuron which has the capacity of producing an additional chemokine signal molecule or the chemical messenger molecule called the hormones along with its normal neurotransmitter signals. So they have like the normal processes as per the normal neuron concerned, but at the same time it also has the property to secrete some sort of peptide hormones or peptide pro hormones which can be transcribed or which can be translated rather into its axon region, and finally it releases all that hormone and can lead to some sort of endocrine type of responses. So this endocrine responses are sometimes considered as a neuroendocrine responses, and they simply like the secretion, and it is like a secretion are usually going into the bloodstream, and then from there is transmitted to the body for the relevant signaling of a specialized organ or places or maybe some other endocrine glands. Now hypothalamus was is going to be our first topic on this particular section. So hypothalamus is actually a basal part of the, it is a basal part of the forebrain, and it's like the structure is a cluster of neurons that are there present there, and this particular structure, it consists of those neurosecretory cells called the hypothalamic nuclei. So I'll show you a slide with those nucleus as diagram. It's just represented in a diagram and all. So they are responsible for the secretion of certain hormones, which has got both trophic and inhibitory type of activity. Trophic activities are, or trophic hormones are those variety of hormone which has the property to induce release of certain things, maybe certain secretions that can be another hormone or that can be some other chemical. Not only that, trophic also is usually responsible for stimulating development and growth also. So anywhere we hear the term trophic is coming, it means it has the property to stimulate that part. Now if we keep this thing aside, still hypothalamus has got the property of regulating functions of different other section of the brain. Means it is not only that this particular gland is responsible for secretion of hormones and doing those per function and so, but along with it, this is also responsible for regulating our body's homeostatic condition. One of them being the temperature. It is actually responsible for regulating our body's temperature. So whenever we find we are getting warmer or feverish, or even we are getting cold and we are sweating and then we are shivering because of it, it is all because of the signal that has been sent by the hypothalamus. It is considered as the thermostat of the body. Now talking about its endocrine type activity, so this particular gland or this particular section of the brain, it actually regulates majorly, its major function is to regulate the function of the pituitary gland. Now any time you have heard this word, you know that this pituitary gland is that particular, it's also part of the brain definitely, but it's also the part which is, or also the gland which is actually responsible for controlling every single secretion of hormonal glands of the entire body. That's why to some extent it is considered as the master gland. Now this particular master gland, it is under the regulation of the hypothalamus, isn't it? So that way our hypothalamus, it becomes the grandmaster, because it is the one which actually controls the master gland. So it becomes a grandmaster gland of our body. Now, this particular grandmaster gland, it actually has different sort of secretions, definitely. Some of them being atrophic type, as I mentioned before, and some of them being an inhibitory type. I mean, somewhere it actually inhibit the process of like whatever process secretion it is actually doing. Let me cite an example before moving on ahead with it. So, like for example, if we consider that it has got the property of the growth hormone, means releasing of the growth hormone. So it is considered as a growth hormone releasing hormone that it actually produces, which goes to the the pituitary gland, and then the pituitary gland secretes the growth hormone necessary for the development and growth of the body. But on the other hand, this also produces the growth hormone inhibiting hormone. So that way, it actually stops the production of growth hormone from the pituitary, and thus our growth, it actually stops. But not only that, it also has the property to go straight away to the tissues, different tissues of the body, and there actually it can warp and stop the process of its growth. Means it counteracts the process of the growth hormone. So that way, this particular hormone, it has the capacity, like these two hormones, they work in sync with each other, and then that way they actually control the growth and development of the entire body. So now let's move ahead and learn about its different parts. See, actually in this image it is shown that the hypothalamus is this large lobular structure with different sections and parts in it. That is true, it definitely has different parts and sections of it, but that will be the part of when somebody is studying the entire neurophysiology. So we are not going for this entirety of the structure. I wanted to show you that particular lobular part, that's why I'm showing you this image. The one we will be considered with will be this image, because this is the one which depicts the internal function or internal arrangement of the entire hypothalamus and how it actually is responsible for regulating the function of the pituitary. Because this image, what you are seeing here, this area is actually the pituitary gland. And this all cells that you are seeing there, this yellow color cells, they are actually the hypothalamic cells or the hypothalamic nuclei. You remember, those are the neurosecretory cells. So what we are seeing here is there are cells which are like this one, which are responsible for direct release of the hormone onto the blood capillaries that are flowing inside. Whereas this other set of hormone, they are going straight into the pituitary section. So this is actually the posterior pituitary. So this is the anterior pituitary, and this is the posterior pituitary right there. And we are going to find that its two different sections are responsible for... Wait a second. This is written as the neurohypophysis. So this will be the posterior pituitary, and this is the anterior pituitary then. So these are actually... this two part is actually the section where so these two parts are actually releasing the hormone to that particular section, and then whatever regulation it's supposed to take place, it happens. So when we talk about this kind of processes, means release of all these different type of hormones onto this different section, so each and every one of the part is actually responsible for controlling its secretion. So let me just give a brief, this few cells, they are releasing the hormone straight onto the blood. That means this blood will carry the hormone along with it and will pass it to the different part of the body. But not necessarily that, because one of the function of these hormones are also to get stored and modified in the pituitary gland. I'll come to that later. So now let's learn about the secretions and what things does it control. So when we talk about the entire process of the secretion of this particular gland or neurosecretory cells, then we are going to find that they're producing hormone to different sections, as has been shown to you people. Now the anterior pituitary, what it happens is so it is actually going there and getting stored in those area and then being released from there. Okay, so what we are going to get here is all the hormones that are being released from that, it actually is responsible for controlling the thyroid thyroid gland, the adrenal cortex, the mammary gland, the bone tissue development, even the testicular or even the gonadic cells or gonads entirely, even can say. So all these different part of the body, it actually controls. It controls by simply like working on their release, means it actually helps in the stimulating hormone that are supposed to stimulate all these different organ for its development and for its secretion. So it is responsible for regulating the secretion of those particular type of hormones. Like for example, the thyroid stimulating hormone, which is released by the pituitary gland, it is responsible for regulating the secretion of those hormones. Then the corticosteroids, means whatever are going to be released from this adrenal gland, adrenal cortex, it is responsible for controlling the secretion of the ACTH hormone, the one responsible for regulating the secretion of adrenal cortex. It is responsible for the release of those particular hormone which is under control of this. So the thyroid hormone, the hypothalamus hormone, is responsible for controlling the secretion of the pituitary hormone, because ACTH is released by the pituitary. Then the TSH hormone is actually released by the pituitary, and the hypothalamus is responsible for controlling the secretion of those particular hormone. See, what does the prolactin do? Prolactin is responsible for regulating the growth and development and release of milk from the mammary gland. Growth hormone, as you know, is growth and development of the body, muscle, tissues, every part. Gonadic hormones are responsible for growth and development and release of different chemicals and different hormones and the normal secretion of the gametes from the testes and the ovary, and they are all regulated by the pituitary gland. But hypothalamus is responsible for release of those specific hormone which is actually controlling the pituitary secretion. So that way, hypothalamus is in total control of what hormone the pituitary is supposed to release. Not only that, it is also responsible for it actually controls all this process, or it actually is responsible for doing all that, because hypothalamus check the body's condition. I mentioned a while ago that the body's homeostatic condition is what is monitored and regulated by hypothalamus. So whenever the body is in need of those secretions from this specific type of groups of organs, we can say, then it actually needs the pituitary to secrete the inducing hormones, and the hypothalamus checking that will tell the pituitary to go and release those hormones. So that way it is in complete control over the secretion of all those hormonal glands. Not only that, it can also secrete some hormones which are also going to be there stored inside the pituitary, and later will be released upon need. So it also have that kind of process that it produces. Like for example, the vasopressin. The vasopressin hormone is actually the hormone which regulates the function of the kidney, isn't it? Antidiuretic hormone. So it is actually released or produced by the hypothalamus, and all those hormones are getting stored in the pituitary gland, and later whenever it was in need by the body, this hormone will be now released by the pituitary, not the hypothalamus. So in a way, sometimes people think that ADH actually comes from the pituitary. It is true, it does come from the pituitary to the kidney, but it is actually released by the hypothalamus, where it goes to the pituitary, it stays there, it modifies slightly, and then it becomes active enough to get released upon time, and then it regulates the entire function of the secretion of or the glomerular filtration rate in many ways of the kidney. So functioning of the kidney, we can say. So that way this entire gland actually it works, and it actually transmits the signal. Now, as I was saying before, that it actually regulates the pituitary gland, that is true. But this is also responsible for like hormones to get released and stored in the pituitary. So that is what has been depicted here, that all the glands are like whatever hypothalamus, whatever is secreted, it actually gets stored in the pituitary gland, and then they get absorbed into the blood capillaries present in the pituitary region, and from there it actually grows to different part of the body by the systemic flow, and then finally there it actually work on the target cells. So that will sum up the entire hypothalamus, and I'll be sharing a small note along with it. Do read that. So this much is for this particular portion.